Chris again at Friendly Frenzy Games, and today we're going to be walking through the logic and solutions behind all of the puzzles in Escape Simulator's Executive Office Escape Room, which is the third in the Omega Corporation chapter of rooms. If this video helps you, give us a like, drop a comment, and subscribe to Friendly Frenzy Games for many more full Escape Simulator walkthroughs just like this one. So after walking through kind of the office last time, we are now in the executive offices, so we're continuing to move up the corporate ladder here in the Omega Corporation. You can see lots of nice finishes in this office compared to our grunt level in the kind of last set of rooms there. Where we need to do, or kind of what we can start by unlocking, is just this first very simple puzzle with the ties here. And this is going to unlock an area to put in our computer chips. These computer chips are ultimately, by collecting four of them, is what's going to give us the key to escape this room here. So if we kind of unlock this puzzle first, again, it kind of gives us the ability to just kind of drop these puzzles off as we complete them. So all we're trying to do here is select the three ties that we find around the room. So you can see our first one is very obviously on this first kind of corporate leather chair here. We have a blue tie with some yellow crosses. So we can go ahead and pick our second tie here. And on the desk, we have a black tie with kind of blue hexagon looking things, details here. There's only one black tie, so you can't really get it wrong, but it is the third tie here. And our last tie is actually just in the second drawer of this kind of black and gold small little cabinet here under the drawer where we need the key to open the lock. But there's a tie just buried in towards the back of the cupboard here beside the pile of shirts. You can see it's a red tie with white stripes. There are two kind of ready ties on here. One's a little bit more pink, but it has X's and O's. Again, the tie that we just picked up is very clearly a red tie with kind of white waves on here. So we'll go ahead and pick the second to last tie. And you can see with those three ties, again, we have our four open chip slots here. So I'm just gonna throw these ties out so we can kind of, again, just clean as we go and help keep us organized here. So with that now, I think the easiest one to start on maybe is the computer here with the cassette tape that we need to start with. So we can go ahead and open this drawer. Obviously we see that we need some sort of tape cassette in here, and then we also need a way to kind of wind the tape. And what we're going to need to do is, if you haven't noticed yet, which you probably wouldn't have unless you've been in the room already, there are two red switches on either side of this kind of corporate desk here. And what you need to do is essentially press them at the same time, or you need to press them within enough time of each other. So you'll see as soon as you click one, it starts lighting up. You need to make sure that you hit this other switch in time before it resets. If you do that, it opens both of these desks' top drawer at the same time. So we have our cassette tape now. We're able to go ahead and drop that into the deck here. And you can see that we have a screen now that we're gonna need to do a little bit of adjustments for to actually tune it in appropriately. And that's where we're going to need a tool for here. And where we're gonna find that is actually just in this cabinet here. But again, we know we need to unlock our key. Actually, I guess the screwdriver is in the bottom of that cabinet, so we don't need the key just yet, but we will need a key to eventually unlock that top drawer. So anyways, go into the bottom drawer of this kind of black and gold cabinet that we found underneath where we found our red and white tie. And inside is the screwdriver box. You're going to want to open that up and grab the screwdriver, and you'll see there's three different kind of head attachments here as well. I'm just going to toss this out. What we want to do is just have a quick look and see what kind of screwdriver head we're going to need to be able to kind of use this appropriately. So if we go through and inspect our heads here, we have a hexagonal, octagonal shaped kind of head here, so we know this isn't the right one. We have a triangular shaped head, we know that this isn't the right one. And then very clearly our kind of square head, we know we have a square peg here. So pull up our screwdriver and just click and drag the square head on top, and you can see that we've got that matched up now. I'm just going to throw these heads out of here, and we can pull up our screwdriver and just insert it into the peg there. So you see that we have the ability to kind of spin and tune this a little bit now, and our monitor is now calibrated into a blue square. And what we need to do now, and what I've noticed in doing this room twice, is that these numbers are always different. So I'll kind of walk you through the solution, but I can't actually give you the proper answer here. But you do need to, one note that I do have about this puzzle is that you need to solve it within 7 guesses, otherwise it goes through and resets. But what you need to do is essentially just go through and find, or follow anyways, the series of prompts to guess the number that this computer is thinking. So we'll go ahead. Obviously we can pick between 1 and 100. I'll pick 50 for now as a starting point. So it's obviously much bigger than 50. So we'll go ahead and try 80. So we're close at 80, but it's still bigger. So we'll try 85. It's a bit bigger than 85. Let's try 87. A little smaller. So chances are, if it's bigger than 85, and we put in 87, and it was a little smaller than 87, it's probably 86. Put in 86 and we've guessed it right. So again, you're not gonna get the same answer as me very likely, because I have seen a couple of times now where it is different answers, but if you go through and follow the prompt, the idea and style of the puzzle is all the same. Again, we're just gonna collect the chip that it unlocks here, and it doesn't matter what chip slot you put it in, but this is again where we're gonna put all of our kind of puzzle completion tokens into this quantum computer here. So after having completed that, we can go through and tackle this computer now. What we need to do to first and foremost be able to kind of start solving this is, if you inspect this computer really quickly, you'll see that there's a kind of text file here, and it's saying that we need floppy disks to work together. There's going to be red and blue disks. Where we get the blue disk is actually just in this computer here. You can see with the green light, it means that there's a disk in there. You can just hit the eject button and it's going to turn red, but it's going to give us our blue disk so we can put it in our top drive here. And our red disk is actually, again, just in this top drawer here that we're going to need to unlock. And the key is just kind of hidden in one of the plants here. You can see it's just kind of sitting on top of the pod itself. So go ahead and collect the key, turn around and put it in the lock here. And we've unlocked our red floppy disk now. So we can go ahead and put it in the second drive. We have both lights up here now, so we're all good there. Go ahead and cancel out of this text file, and we can go into the Y copy here. So before we actually start this next puzzle, we have to get through the password protection. And if you've noticed around the room here, we have these posters kind of subconsciously here. If you've noted any of them, obviously we have info games under the kind of colorful armadillo or turtle, whatever this is here. We have Bullfly, we have Similaris. There's a couple other ones here. Martial Arts, 14th Century Entertainment. All you're trying to do is match up the correct kind of name for the company with their image. So we said we had info games as the colorful turtle. We had Similaris as this kind of ring here. We had Bullfly as this one here. The only one that we don't know on that wall is this one here. But if you actually pay attention to the pictures on top of this cabinet, we have Brainscape here and we have Hypnosis. So Brainscape and Hypnosis. Obviously we know we don't have this one included on that puzzle, so we can throw that one. But what we're looking to add is the Brainscape for this second image here. Once we complete that password puzzle, we are now into the Y copy professional. So you're gonna wanna hit analyze, and what it's gonna do is, we know we have two floppies, and we know from the text note that these numbers need to work together. All that means is essentially you need to combine our left and right side to be able to come out with one number. So you can see here that our first sector is very clearly a 2. Even if you add this on top, it's still gonna kind of give you that 2 anyways. So we're all good. Our first number, obviously with sector 1, our first number is going to be 2. Our second one here is a little bit more confusing. I initially thought it was just like a 3 kind of backwards and forwards, but what you actually need to do is, again, add the left and right side. So if you were to add these two together, it's gonna spit out an 8. You can kind of visualize that by overlapping these two together, but our second number for sector 2 here is gonna be an 8. And then similarly here for our third number, if you were to add the top of the 7 here to kind of the up and down side of the 7 here, we are going to have, again, a 7 if you add these two pieces or overlap them together. So to actually unlock it now, we'll go to the unlocker EXE and just type in 287 and hit OK. And we've unlocked that now, and we've got our second quantum chip. Go ahead and plug that in. Now our next puzzle here is we can go to our purple computer here, and you'll see that it says to dial the BBS number. Dial being the important part. Obviously BBS is another part that we can kind of look for in our clue. And one thing that you might not have noticed so much is kind of what's going on in our background outside the window. You can see here that BBS, obviously purple and black, and kind of written in the same kind of scripture as our screen here. But there's actually a phone number here, or a number that we can call. And this is what we need to type into that computer to kind of get this rolling here. So we have 555-256-222. So we'll go ahead and plug that in. 555-256-222. And hit OK, and you'll see that we get a secret code. And this is saying from dawn to sunset, hidden in plain sight, and three. Three is meaning that we're looking for three numbers. And if you look out this window again here, you'll see that we have a noon radio at 279, or 27.9. We have evening and channel 4 news. Those numbers aren't what matter. It's actually the kind of window formations of the numbers underneath in the buildings here. So you can see at noon we have a 6, at evening we have 8. What we're actually missing though, because again we know we're looking for three numbers, what we're missing is the morning. And the morning is actually just out our left window here. So you'll see we have our morning delight. And again, our secret code set from dawn to sunset. So we know obviously from earliest time in the day to the latest time in the day gives us our order. And we're going to go from morning being 2 to noon being 6 and evening being 8. So we can go ahead and do 2, 6, 8 and hit OK. And we have this unlocked now. And here is our third chip. That into the computer there, and now we have our last kind of puzzle here, and it is just going to be this basic 10 cheat sheet. So go ahead and open this keyboard compartment here, and we have instructions on how to actually use this terminal here. So as you can see, we have a couple of different commands and prompts. What this is telling us is this is what the expected output is going to be. This is what we need to recreate. And how we do that is if we just follow along with these clues here. So to be able to first print hello, we have this print hello button. We need to hit that. So this is telling us basically just print commands displays text on the screen. Example, print hello. The word hello will be outputted onto the screen. So the first puzzle in this is relatively simple. We need to make sure we have hello and then world. All we're going to do for level one is hit print hello and print world and then hit run code. You'll see our outputs there, and if it matches up with the expected, it'll tell us that we've moved on to level two. Now it gets a little bit more complicated in that we have to add some color codes to this. So what it's saying now is for text outputted on the screen after this command will be in the chosen color. So we know again to add this, we have to put our text color prompt in, and we also need to make sure that we add the color that kind of corresponds with that. We need to make sure that we input the number that corresponds with that color in as well. And then we put in the word that we want it to say. So what that's going to look like, if we wanted to print hello in red, we need to first put in our text color prompt and use our legend at the bottom here. We see that for red, we have to put in 2. So it'll be text color 2, and then anything after this is going to show up red. We want hello is red, so our second line will be print hello. Our next one here, we know we're changing colors and we're changing the word. So we're going to put in text color, and it's going to be 5 for cyan. So we'll go ahead and put that in, and now we're going to put in world. And then we're basically just repeating our first prompt. We're going to go back to text color 2 for red, and it's going to be hello again, and we will run our code. And now with that level complete, we have a series of 3 hellos and 10 worlds here. And for this last one, we have obviously on number 3, for using the for command, you can make a loop. Loops start with for command and end with the next command. So for this example, if we did the for I equals 1 to 5 and print world next I, world is gonna show 5 times on the screen. We know we want hello to show up 3 times, but we need to start with the for I equals 1 to x. And our x obviously is gonna be 3 because we want it to show up 3 times on the screen. So we'll do for I equals 1 to 3 the first time and do print hello. But to make sure we close this loop now, we have to hit next I. And again, we have 10 worlds here, but our 1 to X counter only goes to 9. So if we go through and hit print world now, this is going to give us our first kind of 1, or maybe our 10th, however you want to look at it. And now we can run our next loop command for I equals 1 to X. We'll make it 9 for our last 9 in this sequence here. We'll go print world and then close our loop and hit run code. And you can see that we have our 3 hellos. We get our 10 worlds and the compartment is unlocked. We'll grab our last chip here and put it into the chip slot. And you can see as soon as we input those, we have our door key here. Put the door in the elevator key here. And we have finished the executive office now, which is the third escape room in the Omega Corporation series of rooms in Escape Simulator. Hopefully you guys found this video helpful. If you did, give us a like and subscribe to Friendly Frenzy Games for many more guides and walkthroughs just like this one.